Welcome to Anatomy of an Artwork. So this is where I walk you through step by step how I create my artworks. So this one is really, really embarrassing for me to post. So it's from a job I did about 2 years ago and I haven't posted it yet because I've been really embarrassed because I broke one of my cardinal rules and I stuffed up a project. Like, I fixed it, but you'll see the point where things went a bit wrong, and I'll show you how I fixed it in the end. I'll jump into it straight after this brief announcement. Hi guys, I get asked a lot of questions about painting murals professionally, so I've created a free mini course, the 7 essential steps to making it as a mural artist. So these are my top 7 things that you need to know when you're starting out working with clients to paint murals for money. As I said before, this course is totally free. To access it, just sign up to my mailing list. It's either via the link in my bio or below. I'd love to have you on board with this, so please sign up to get started today. The project was a mural in a new restaurant that was being built, so I had a very short time span to do this one. So to get the outlines of these 3 figures that I had to paint, I used a projector and sketched them up. So that's what I'm doing here. I don't always like using projectors, and I actually try not to use them very much because I feel like you get a better result if you don't use them. But in cases where I just have to get the job done really fast, then they come in really handy if you've got the space and you can change the lighting so that they still work. So after all the lines are drawn up, basically I'm going to smash out those main figures in the middle. So they are, part of them's black and white and they're wearing butcher's aprons, which are like a really dark blue. So in the interest of doing it as quickly as possible, I start off with just doing all the black and white areas. So that's the clothing of the butchers and their arms and necks. So I just go along for the 3 figures and do each of them. So I'm just layering the paint on and just blocking in the colors and using quite big brushes. So my technique for doing tattoos and even just patterns and things like that on clothing is I just paint it in actually quite flat. I don't worry about the shadows and the highlights, just try and follow the contours of the body with the tattoo. And then what I do later is I go back in with some diluted paint and I add the shadows over the top and then the highlights on the skin, and that makes the tattoo look convincing and real and like it's wrapping around a body part. So next I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to do the butcher's aprons, which are in like a really deep inky blue color. So I just basically paint them in very flat. There's no shading here, it's just blocks of that color, and I sort of try and follow the contours of the apron with the lines, but I wait until the paint is dry and then I use either diluted white paint to do some highlights and then some diluted black paint for the shadows, and that's what gives the illusion of 3D material that's folding around the body, but it doesn't take too long to actually paint. So that's a really good trick and I use that one a lot. Okay, here's the bit where things went really wrong. So everything was looking great up until I got to the background. So I had originally shown the client a concept where the colors butt up against each other, so there's no white space in between them, and that's what they had signed off on. But then on the day, I decided that I could do it faster if the colors were separated by a line of tape, which meant that I wouldn't have to wait as long for the paint to dry and I could get it done faster, because remember, this job had to be done really quickly. So this was a huge mistake, because basically whatever you show the client in a concept, you actually have to come through with for the artwork, otherwise that they can be disappointed in the final result. So that's exactly what happened here. So this is not something I've ever done before, making this mistake, so all I can say is in my defense, I'd been going through a really rough period of like a month of extreme insomnia. So I hadn't been sleeping. I'd been taking prescription sleeping pills. So yeah, I was definitely not thinking clearly when I did this, and I was just like, yeah, it'll be fine. And it wasn't. So watch on to see how that all unfolded and how I fixed it. After I painted in the background, aka the wrong background, I went ahead and did all the outlines on my figures. So this is one of my favorite parts. I love the way the outlines just kind of neaten it up and just pull it all together. So that was the finished mural, and the client had a massive problem because of those white outlines between all the colors, and they were completely right about that, because that was not what I'd shown them in the concept. So I had to have a very difficult conversation over the phone, and I offered to go back and fix up the mural and get rid of those white lines. This was an absolute bastard of a thing to have to fix, because I had to go in and retape everything, and the areas that were white and were actually supposed to be white, like those vertical little bars, I had to retape them exactly in the positions they were in before. And then I had to go and kind of like inset the tape on all the other bands to get the color to match up perfectly. Anyway, it's difficult to explain. You'll see what I'm doing in the clip, but I can tell you that I felt pretty sad about having messed it up in the first place. I can tell you that much. But, you know, the reason I'm posting this video for you guys is to show that, you know, mistakes happen. Everyone makes mistakes, and you can come back from it and you can fix them and make the mural great. And here's the finished mural. So I actually do prefer this more. So lesson learned here is always paint what you tell the client you're gonna paint, and don't take sleeping pills. Hope you enjoyed watching this one, guys. A thumbs up would be great if you enjoyed it, or leave a comment below if you've ever made any major mistakes on a project or had problems with insomnia. I'd love to hear about it.